Hello, this is Teleosaurus, and welcome to part 6 of my series on the evolution of muzzleloader design based on what I have in my collection. Tonight is the Flintlocks. As you can see, I don't have too much in the way of the true Flintlocks, or as they were originally known as the French lock, which was because at the time you had so many different types from so many different countries, and these particular designs were invented by a family in northern France in the early 1620s. The first gun here is a Peter Sully second shortland pattern brown best that I built from a kit, but it shows typical of design features of a 1700s musket. As you can see, by this time the screw, compared to from my earlier video, is attached to a bridle, which is attached to the flash pan. The lock is now not much so much a banana shape, it's just a very long, heavy lock. And of course, the stock design is something that you would be more familiar with, you know, with a modern gun. And of course, over here is the bayonet. Believe me, at this time, by the beginning of the 1700s, they were replacing plug bayonets, which fit over the muzzle, with the socket bayonet. As so. And it was a very simple mechanism. That was what you think is the front sight on this gun is actually the bayonet lug. And as you can see, that's a pretty big pig sticker. That's going to mess up anybody's day. But it at least enabled them to have a bayonet mounted while they were loading the gun. Next was a gun which was patterned, I'll just get this over here, based on the early 1800s Plains rifles. This one is a TC Renegade. And there was a transitional type of an Eastern long rifle, but I don't have one of those, so sorry about that. It was basically a rifled gun that was like as long as a musket, but much smaller caliber, like up to 45, 50, you know, down to 32 caliber. This one is a 75. This one is a 50 caliber. And you can see that it was typical of the early style Plains guns where they, to reduce weight, they shortened the barrel and shortened the stock and made the caliber bigger. That was because of the heavier, more dangerous game. They would go all the way up to 58 caliber with these, but this one's just a 50. And as you can see with the sights, this one's a rifle. And again, you know, you got this typical pattern here. If you can see it. Got the bridle. By this time in the 1800s, some of the English designers were actually using rollers over down here on the spring or on the frizzen spring, which enabled it to actually achieve even faster lock times. These guns are actually pretty fast. And this one also has a double trigger. The single set trigger is basically a very heavy trigger to use if you use it without any other assistance. And this one, I'll show you what you're going to do. Basically, right now this is a very heavy trigger, see? But if you click on this, hear that click? Now this has become a very light feather trigger. As such, just a slight tilt, and that's it. And that speeds up lock time by quite a bit. And that's it for this one. I'll be able to show you an example of my long rifle in my next series, which is on the percussion guns. Okay, have a good day, and keep your powder dry.